One of Australia's biggest beneficiaries from COVID, Sonic Healthcare, has today put out a not surprisingly healthy profit update. Business editor Ross Greenwood joins us. Ross, we should say that profits are up because it provided the service of vaccination to the community.
It sure did, and lots of them as well. And so that's the reason why. Of course, the PCR tests and then also vaccinations. And Sonic Healthcare is Australia's largest pathology business with all of the brands that you probably know, has really done pretty well out of all of this. So if we take a quick look at its profit, what you can see here is these are quarterly results that have come out with its annual meeting today. Its sales are up by 5%, $3.0 billion for this quarter alone. The profit here is 16%. Is to $991 million and up 16%. The other thing also that I thought was interesting about this is it actually gave detail as to exactly how much work it's been doing during this period of time. So if we take one quick look here, what you can see is the company's actually reported that it's actually administered 1 million COVID vaccinations. Now, in the whole scheme of things, that's not a whole lot. But what it has done is done a lot of those PCR tests. That's where really it's done a lot of the work over the past 12 months or so. So 1 million COVID vaccinations, but see here, 36 million COVID tests it's administered and obviously done the work in analysing those as well, just to help keep the community safe. So on one hand, you say, well, you know, they are a beneficiary from COVID, but on the other, you say you did need these services to help fight off the effects of the pandemic that's taken place.
It's not the only company reporting today. There's Aristocrat, which makes poker machines, but this is pretty odd. Its profit has jumped 81% despite the lockdowns.
Yeah, OK, so that's the one side of it. And when you think about it, Australia with all the lockdowns, and Aristocrat is certainly an Australian company and manufactures and has technology for some of the most significant gaming machines on the planet, it's in America where it's actually made its money. So here, as you point out, the profit is up by some 81%. In fact, it's up by 114% on a normalised basis, $756 million. But have a look at the revenues, up by 14%. That's about America being opened because, obviously, where the slot machines are is in America. Aristocrat is one of the leaders in the world at this type of technology. But just have a look at that revenue. It's enormous revenue in a COVID year for the sale of new machines, which is really quite interesting. And, of course, this has been seen when clubs have been opened here, but also, obviously, big casinos around the world. People have gone back to them in droves, and this is the reason why many pubs and clubs have actually been able to survive in the sort of shape that they have, is simply because there's been an appetite for people to go and punt.
Okay, makes sense now. It's well known many Australian companies are in pretty good shape as well. And today, Treasury Wine spent $434 million on a Napa Valley wine company in California. Sounds good to me.
So this is a cracking story, this. So the business that they've bought is called the Frank's Family Vineyard. But the story behind it is kind of cool because Rich Frank was formerly a president of Disney Studios. Like, he's a Hollywood type. So he was behind a whole bunch of things you'd know, like The Golden Girls. He was behind Pretty Woman. He was behind a whole range of other things. Home Improvement was another one of his. Anyway, so what's happened is that he went out with his family and bought one vineyard, then a number of others, and they've become really big. So Treasury statement says that Frank Family Winery fills a key portfolio gap for luxury Chardonnay. Some of the Chardonnays go for $250 US a pop. Now, they do start at about $35, so you can get a cheaper one. But the lovely story that's behind this is that Rich Frank tells a story just a little while ago. Apparently, it's an apocryphal story, he says, is in the old days when they bought it, it used to be a champagne house. And so what would happen is that apparently, apocryphally, that you'd have Marilyn Monroe go out there and acquire her champagne for her champagne bars from this place, right? So it's quite a nice little story. And the Australian company Treasury Wines, which is known for Penfolds, a range of other brands here in Australia, has gone out and bought that business today. There you go, Laura.
I love that. I didn't think we'd be talking about Marilyn Monroe wine and gambling this morning, but I appreciate it and welcome it. Ross Greenwood, good to see you.